Out there filming my bike.
Very up until it comes out.
Yeah.
Can you introduce yourself for everyone?
I'm Vince from Suburban Legends, and I do vocals and a little bit of interpretive dance.
I'm Ryan Kline from Suburban Legends. I play guitar and I'm watching interpretive dance.
Do you have a new album coming?
Let's Be Friends is accumulation and a cornucopia of, if you took everything we've ever done, CDs, DVDs, artwork, personal conflict, and you smashed it into about 700 megabytes, and you burned it on a disc. That's what it is.
It's a buffet of like all the records that we've done, like the ska, the disco, the pop, funk. It's like there's like a couple songs of each of it on the album. You got your ska songs, you got your disco songs, you got your eclectic songs that you make you like this, but oh, it's good. I still like it.
Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah. It's just a buffet of different types of songs.
Yeah, we really try to cater to everybody.
Did you do anything different on this album than your previous albums?
We played ska. We haven't played ska in two albums.
We did a lot of, we looked within ourselves in introspection and then found some good songs.
We did a little more rock on this album.
Yeah.
We haven't done that.
We also did some songs that we Clem and I wrote like 8 years ago or 6 years ago, and somehow they made it on the album.
Yeah, for the first time we worked with a songwriter.
Yeah, we did. First time we worked with a songwriter.
How many more times are they going to drive by? That's like the one time.
We're going to follow them a little bit.
Yeah, we actually.
How do you guys like your new bikes?
It's all right.
Your motorcycle?
Better.
Yeah.
I don't want to bring the good stuff out here.
That's only the fifth one I got. It's a pretty sweet ride.
Have you decided on a single yet?
Oh, the single?
I'll take Girl's Got What I Want.
Girl's Got What I Want. It's a good single.
That's the one that everyone likes the most so far.
That one, but I mean, a lot of. Yeah, and then a couple of the other ones were put up online. So it's hard to say. I don't know. I think depending on who it is, the single's gonna be different.
I think it's up to the public of whether they want to say anything.
Yeah.
How many songs did you initially write for the album, and how did you narrow it down?
Close to like 24 songs, and then we narrowed down to 13. Yeah.
No, we recorded. I think we recorded like 16 or 17 songs, and then like 3 or 4 didn't make it on it.
Yeah. So we got a total of 12 songs plus maybe something.
Hidden track.
You're out on tour with Leslie Jake and Goldfinger and Vicky and the Kids Table. How's the tour been going so far?
Incredible.
It's like summer camp. Everyone's like best friends. Like, oh, we missed you guys yesterday. It's good to see you. We had a day off.
Yeah, the vibe is really cool in this tour. Everybody's really friendly, nice, and like the every single night the reception's been huge. It's been really cool.
And everyone watches each other. All the bands watch each other's set.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, how was Goldfinger's set last night? Darren Pfeiffer lighting his drums on fire?
That was
right? And then the Braveheart stint? That was
pretty. The solos they were taking
Kelly,
and stuff?
Kelly and Charlie had phenomenal solos last night. They were in rare form.
Yeah. Yeah, this tour's been cool, because like sometimes headliners don't even like, you know, you don't see them, they disappear.
I don't talk to them.
Not on this one. This one's really cool.
This one's like, alright, you're done. Set, let's go have a drink. It's really cool.
Do you have any funny tour stories?
Darren in Canada. No, not Canada. Milwaukee. He did the Twinkie out of the bomb, you know. And he got arrested after he got off stage and he got detained.
Did he really?
Yeah.
That's nuts.
I think that's it. I think he just got like a skull.
And then there was also the time where somebody, or Darren ate the Twinkie out of somebody else's ass. That was pretty cool.
And then that dude called in to a radio station that we were doing an interview at a radio station the next day, and the dude that actually ate it out of her. That had Darren eat it out of his butt, called in.
Yeah.
Telling us how awesome. He's like, you guys are awesome, by the way. I ate Twinkie out of that.
Oh, yeah, that guy. They posted her, like, really set. It's really tentative right now, but playing a tour, push the album.
Yeah, Jonas Brothers would be awesome. Because that would be really big and really sold out.
You formed the band about 10 years ago. What's been the most memorable experience of
the fact that it's been that long is very memorable.
Yeah, but I always kind of like, we've only been touring
We've been touring since like 2002 or 3.
Oh, 2004. 2004 from Munchie.
When we really started touring.
Yeah.
I got a question for you guys. If Goldfinger and Less Than Jake had to fight each other in a death cage match, who would win?
Goldfinger.
Why?
I don't know, because they play angrier music and you figure they got a fury inside.
But you never
them.
Know. Sometimes when people have that fury, like, it's the people that don't have it that
it's
really...
people you don't expect it.
That have the most fury. Like,
it's where the little guy turns into a dragon and eats all the tough guys.
Because it's so pent up, you know? Yeah. It's just like an atomic bomb.
So do you think?
I don't want to see that fight. It's like that would be like
Chris turning into a dragon.
That would be like anti-gravity dark matter sucking in everything and light because this is too intense for anybody to actually consume.
Well done.
Is there any other upcoming band that you really like?
That
people should know about.
What is
Maldroid? Maldroid, yeah, Maldroid? And the Jonas Brothers.
Yeah, no one's heard of them.
Maldroid's really good, yeah.
They're from Northern California. They have members of Band of Soul Mind, KGB in it.
Yeah. And they're just really good.
I Hate Kate too. Justin's band.
Yeah. I Hate Kate.
What is one thing that most people do not know about your band?
That we're not really as tough as we seem, you know? We're not as aggressive as people really point us out to be.
We may look really scary on stage when we're doing our fun dances and playing our fun music. We're really harmless.
We're really grounded and we just want to, you know, make friends.
Even though we talk about fighting all the time.
And we do get in fights a lot.
All the time.
To, you know,
we're really nice.
We're really nice.
We don't really fight at all. That's like our I think we wear our personalities and our lives on our sleeve.
Is there anything else you looked at that maybe we didn't cover in the interview or...
Let's Be Friends, Pick It Up. It's our brand new album. Just came out today. It's going to be online on iTunes hopefully in the next month or two, so check it out. Yeah.
Can I have one more? This will be the soundtrack to your summer since The Dark Knight's coming out soon. There's a song on our album called Villain, and it's about the Joker. Represent.
Oh, wait, do that again. Wow, let's get a close up of that. Where'd you get that done?
In California, Fullerton.
So yeah, Let's Be Friends, please pick it up. We're very proud of it.
And you guys would be proud of it too, I think.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.